Hi, I'm Cathy, and in this video, I'm going to share some more information about our latest deck, which is Medical Surgical Nursing Edition 2. This deck has been completely reimagined, and it's bigger and better than before. In this video, I am going to share some of the new features of this deck, and then also show you some examples of cards from this deck. So one of the first new features of this deck is that we've included an anatomy and physiology review for each of the 10 body systems. So this is not like a full-blown anatomy and physiology deck, but it does provide a nice review and foundation so that you can understand how a body system is supposed to work, so you can better understand what to expect if a body system malfunctions due to a disease or disorder. For some body systems, this AMP review is very short. Like for the integumentary system, we simply go into the different skin layers. But for like the endocrine system, the AMP section is a little bigger because we go through each of the hormones, what it's, you know, what their functions are in the body, and what controls release of those hormones. So that takes a number of cards to go through that information. So in addition to an AMP review with each body system, in this deck, we have also included pathophysiology and critical care topics. So over the last couple years, lots of students have asked me to make a patho deck or a critical care deck. However, there is a great deal of overlap between what is covered in a pathophysiology class and what is covered in a medical surgical class, and what is covered in a critical care class. And it really makes sense to cover these topics together so that you don't have to go through redundant information in separate decks. So in your patho class, in a typical patho class, you go over why and how a disease process takes place in the body. And then you also usually cover signs and symptoms of the disease, lab values, diagnostics, treatment, and maybe go into a little bit of nursing care. Well, in medical surgical nursing, you may not go into as much detail about the patho, but you still cover those same signs and symptoms, labs, diagnostics, treatment, and then you maybe go into more detail about nursing care and patient teaching. So you can see there's like all this overlap. So it just really made sense to bring these topics together. And then when it comes to critical care nursing, most critical care concepts deal with complications of diseases and disorders that you cover in medical surgical nursing. For example, diabetes is a key disorder that we talk about in medical surgical nursing. If diabetes is not managed properly, or if a patient has an infection, they can end up with life-threatening complications such as DKA and HHS. So in order to understand DKA and HHS, you really need to understand diabetes. And that is why I've combined these three topics into one deck. Other new features of this deck include an index at the end of the deck so you can quickly look up a disease or disorder and go straight to that card in the deck. This index is color-coded by body system, so it's really easy to use. We've also included many of my silly hints or mnemonics kind of sprinkled throughout the deck. These hints are designated with a little cool chicken icon, and I'll show you some examples when I show you some cards. And then we've also included references to our other decks at the bottom of many of the cards. And I'll show you some examples of this and explain why we've done that. So to give you a feel for some of the cards, I've pulled some examples out of the GI system. So in the GI system, of course, the small intestine is part of that. If you turn it over here, you'll see some information about the structure and functions of the small intestine. We have one of our little cool chicken hints there at the top. And you'll notice that the word absorption is in bold and red, which means that's an important thing to remember as it pertains to the small intestine. Also, as part of our AMP review for each of the body systems, we've included full color illustrations. So here's an example of one of those illustrations in the GI system. I love this drawing and I wish I had it when I was in nursing school, but this gives you a good visual description of the biliary tract, which will be really helpful, especially when you're talking about cholelithiasis. So that's an example of a drawing. Let's look at what you can expect to find in terms of information for each disorder. So if we look at pancreatitis, you'll notice here at the top of the card, we have a definition of the disorder in italics at the top. Then we go into the pathophysiology behind pancreatitis, then risk factors, signs and symptoms. Again, you'll see one of my little cool chicken icons there at the bottom. And then on the next card, we have the labs that you will see with pancreatitis, as well as diagnostic testing, treatment, nursing care, and patient teaching. Again, you'll notice that some of the text is in bold and red, so you definitely need to know those things. And then at the bottom of the card, you'll see those DEC references that I was talking about. So for this example, you'll see that we're referencing several different cards in our pharmacology deck. So that will let you pull those cards and get more details on the medications used to treat pancreatitis. And then we also have references to our lab values deck. So if you want more information about the expected ranges of these lab values, you can pull those cards out of our lab values deck as well. So hopefully that gives you a feel for what these cards look like and how they're organized. Okay, so to sum up, I know this is a big deck. It seems like a lot of cards, and it is a lot of cards, but it is divided into 10 body systems. And if you tackle one body system at a time, it is very manageable. Plus, this deck will take you through many of your classes. So pathophysiology, medical surgical nursing, which for some students, that's like two or three semesters, and critical care nursing. So it really is designed to help you with a number of your classes. In addition, we have our Level Up learning system available to help you organize your deck by body system and keep track of your progress when learning the information on those cards. So I definitely advise you to take a look at that. I love using my learning system to help organize my cards. So hope you love this deck. Can't wait to get your feedback. Take care and good luck studying.